There is one thing that I want to ask you, and I have asked you, you haven't answered. I want you to answer.
What?
You hated the people of Uganda?
Why?
You hated the
show. And welcome back to Jeff Koinange live at the Intercontinental Hotel. Clearly, the gentlemen are still at it, even during commercial break, because it's a hot topic. Don't mess with sugar, especially when it comes to Kenya and Uganda. And I'm saying welcome back on the day that Kenya, yes, right, gentlemen, there's a bit of good news today. For the very first time in Kenyan history, a Kenyan won in a field event at an international event. Not only won, but got the gold. Julius Yego.
Yes.
Fantastic.
Thank you.
And of course, having, what's her name, having Jepkemoi,
yes,
won the 3,000 meter steeplechase.
For the first time.
So Kenya has six gold medals
and 400 meters hurdles.
Yes. Nicholas Bett
for the first.
Fantastic. Yeah. Fantastic.
That is Kenya.
That's very good. East Africa.
Yeah.
That's East Africa.
How you wish.
I'm sorry. Well, what did East Africa come in?
We are very sorry.
East Africa. represent where they are running from is China. They represent Africa. African countries that are happy.
Okay, let's go.
Let's go.
Yeah, we're talking sugar. We're talking other issues.
We shall.
Okay, let me read some tweets real quick, Mweshimiwa.
Yes, yes.
Yeshure Kimoi says, you should sit in the middle of these two gentlemen. Anything can happen. Others were commenting that, I feel like the guest here.
Because you have taken part.
I've taken part in what?
Tearing the paper.
Okay, Nkosinati Butelezi says, Matsanga should stick to ICC matters. You have no knowledge of sugar.
You see.
Nkosinati says this.
Neil, go ahead, read.
Dan Kahia says, please tell Matsanga to debate. He can for theatrics and shouting.
And funny things. I have not shouted. You know that very well. I've been calm today. Read more. There are good ones there. You are not reading.
Proceed.
But anyway.
Matsanga, before the break, Daktari here commented about your lack of knowledge and Uganda.
He doesn't have any.
314,000 metric tons a year.
He got it from
somewhere on the sheet here.
Yes.
And they consume a lot more than they produce.
But the rules of debate require that if a document is supposed to be subject of the debate,
it
has to be authentic.
Yes.
This is not
I'm not in the parliament.
Respond.
He's used to parliament procedures.
How do I debate on another?
There is one problem that I liked this guy, the way he debates in parliament, until I saw him debate the Ruto debate, where you actually collapsed, you failed the motion. But let's move to the realities. The realities are this.
Mm-hmm.
I want the senator to answer me. And a quick one, no more debate.
Yes.
Do you hate people of Uganda?
Yes.
Do you hate the sugar?
Yes.
Or do you people who hate the president? Because it looks
okay,
like...
Okay, you have asked the question.
Let me answer.
Yeah. Yes.
Answer me. Who, the three categories, what do you hate?
My love for Ugandans.
Yes.
My love for the Republic of Uganda.
Yes.
And my love for President Museveni does not amount to Uganda having the capacity to export sugar. It has no export sugar. You have been hiding in Kenya for almost 10 years. Have you ever seen Ugandan sugar here at the hotel where you stay?
Yes.
You've never seen
it. I've drunk Uganda sugar. Okay, you have answered my question.
My love does not translate into the surplus sugar.
There's now reason intellectually.
Yeah. Yes.
There are serious issues.
Yes.
Is it the management of the sugar industry in Kenya? Because, Jeff, when we come to a national television like this, as much as we want to show our capability to debate, we need also to advise so that people take our advice. How do we solve this crisis of the sugar crisis? Is it the mismanagement of the sugar crisis that has caused the problem that we see?
Well, Senator Khalwale has said that
Khalwale knows very well that Uganda sugar, which is a fact, even if they export the surplus they have, it will not remove the deficit that Kenya has. That is a fact.
But you heard what his argument was.
Uganda consumes $700 million worth of goods
from Kenya.
From Kenya.
Kenya's biggest trading partner.
Let's go on. Wanted us to debate. Can I debate?
Proceed.
Analyst, you want to call me another person. Let me tell you, 700 million shillings in our shops, we have a variety of Kenyan goods, including matchbox, which you also produce in Uganda, apparently, but we prefer, we import because there's a choice. Why is it that they, Mr. Kalwale and the co, because you know Mr. Kalwale has a co company, a very serious company which waffles, but he himself does not waffle maybe. Mm. He has a company that always looks at this sugar. It has picked the sugar issue. Yet there is rice imported from Pakistan, which is here in plenty, packed in Mwea sugar rice bags. You have not talked about it. What is your real problem so that we solve it? Because you look, it looks like you have reached, let me finish this before you respond. You have reached a point of diminished responsibility because you don't reason anymore.
Mazanga, let him respond. Mazanga, go ahead,
Mazanga, it is an insult to all Kenyans when a Ugandan purports that he wants to be part of the solution of the sugar crisis. Kenya does not need Uganda to solve our sugar crisis, and worse still, we do not need one Mazanga to solve our sugar problem. If you knew how international trade functions, you would not be sulking at the fact that little things like match boxes are sold from Kenya to Uganda and many other things.
Yes.
That is how it works.
Among
the things the things you sell in a different country are the things that that country does not
have.
I know that.
Come to the
point. If you had sugar, we are on sugar.
I'm not seeing any.
If you had sugar, which you want to purport to sell to Kenya.
Not purport. We have a surplus.
Can you relax?
Which we have sold. And we did not have a deal. By the way, there is Kalwale does not have a paper.
I want him to listen to me.
You don't have a paper.
I want you to listen to me.
Yes, I'm listening.
Listen to me. If you had a pellet of sugar that you could export, you would not have stated in Kenya where there is a booming sugar industry. You would have gone to Rwanda, which is nearer to you.
Yes.
They don't grow a single stem of sugar.
Some sugar from us.
You would have gone to Burundi. Mm. You would have gone to DRC.
Yes.
As minister, assistant minister at the community, I'm aware that there is no pellet of Ugandan sugar that crosses out of Uganda to DRC, to Rwanda or Burundi. It is just a figment of your imagination and hoping and wishing that Uganda could have that capacity.
Yes.
Now, let me educate you on this very critical issue. The issue of contraband goods takes place even today as we speak because of contraband goods. You'll find that goods are coming from Somalia, including sugar.
Yes.
It is not therefore mean that Somalia produces sugar.
Yes.
No.
Why haven't you complained about Somalian sugar coming?
We deal with it as a security. We deal with it as a security issue.
Why don't you complain about Tanzanian sugar?
We deal with it at the community level.
Why in particular?
It is because you don't understand.
What angers me, you are trying to exclude me from the debate of the Uganda-Kenya sugar. At the same time, you are telling me I should not even debate about it.
Gentlemen.
But then you are on all the time. You have hidden something. You are not telling the whole Kenyan, the Ugandan population listening. Are you against the community?
You keep asking that
We have answered you.
You haven't.
We are telling you.
Can
I repeat?
Yes.
We are telling you. I speak for millions of Kenyans.
I also speak for Ugandans who are
really
watching.
Yes. Elected
is
or
this
appointed in
is this, it doesn't need
appointed,
an election.
You and need, appointed in one
you
position.
Can, you, as far as you are Ugandan, what did Obama tell you? By the way, he told us patriotism.
You
speak for your country.
Tell me.
I am speaking for my country. Because for you,
from what
gentlemen,
position?
As a Ugandan, I'm entitled.
Gentlemen, maybe I should leave.
As a Ugandan,
don't forget.
Any criminal cannot speak on behalf.
Gentlemen,
you speak on
Mazanga
of Kenya.
Mazanga, I am here.
By 500,000,
I'll watch.
I am here.
No, you see, he can't purport to speak on behalf of Uganda.
Okay,
if Uganda,
I am a Ugandan.
All right,
and you cannot speak about my country when I'm watching.
Dattari, let me ask you this.
I'll defend myself.
Dattari, let me ask you this.
Let me tell you.
Let's switch gears real quick.
This is important.
Okay,
this is important, so that Kenyans know that this guy is a joker.
In
2012,
I am not a joker.
In 2012,
that's all. Have you removed my nationality?
That in 2012, the current minister of Uganda, Who is the Minister for Constitutional Affairs.
Who is he?
Brought here sugar.
Yes.
In 2011.
His name is Major General Otafire. Let me help you.
Otafire.
Because for you, you are naive.
Otafire.
Naivety has killed you.
Otafire
brought here sugar. I don't want to come down on you. Naivety kills you and you threaten a lot of people.
Go on, Otafire.
Yes, Otafire brought here sugar in 2012.
Yes.
And that sugar was stopped.
Yes.
And it was destroyed.
Yes.
Worth $2.5 million.
Yes.
So people like Otafire, now they are in government.
Yes.
They are ministers. They're the ones who are skimming around Museveni.
Yes.
To fundraise for the forthcoming general election that Museveni fears he's likely to lose.
Yes.
We are not going to sacrifice our farmers because of the breed.
Are you also in the farmers' racket?
We are farmers.
This way.
We are farmers.
I hear in your Kagameka.
Yes, yes.
Because don't get me wrong. Yes.
Debate.
Most of the people got the money from the sugar barons to do an election.
No, the people.
Is it true?
The people.
Are you accusing him of making money?
No, I've not accused
him. Accusing him?
No, I don't accuse.
You can give
I don't accuse poor people like him.
You
I accuse only strong souls. This man is poor in soul.
If you are a strong soul,
this is a poor man.
Why have you run away from your country?
I have not run away.
Instead of defending the interests of your country.
Defend what?
Advancing
the country. Don't I defend? I do.
No.
You know that.
You are just a
good fighter. You know.
You are a hoax.
You are a hoax. Tell you. Let me
for real, you are a hoax.
You are part of the scheme.
You should
in Kenya. In Kenya, you are part of the scheme.
You are enjoying our food. You are enjoying our bed.
You have never
our toilet.
You talk like a cheap person in a village.
I am very sorry,
gentlemen.
You don't.
I don't use the fire extinguisher that often, but you are forcing me.
Yes. Don't talk like a doctor who chooses people.
Why aren't you standing for president in Uganda? You have elections coming up. Why aren't you standing?
Excuse me.
Yes, why
I have told you, Mr. Dr.
Why?
With due respect to Dr. Harare and you, Koinange, who has become a tormentor instead of a person.
Why did you come?
Wait. Let me tell you.
You can't lecture Kenyans on elections.
Harare.
When you haven't stood for
Harare. The Electoral Commission of the Republic of Uganda. Don't want to
finish your sentence.
The Electoral Commission of the Republic of Uganda has not declared one, the date when the elections will be held. Two, the date when candidates should declare.
When they do, will you stand?
Yes.
Will you stand?
I will tell you what post I want.
Which seat?
I want. I am a human.
You are almost 60 years old and you have never run for anything. Are you going to stand for your career?
I have been there before you. What have you built?
You don't even have a clinic. How do you know?
Never even healed a person.
It is because
you just put medicine here and take money from NSF. You shut up.
I will not shut up.
I want you to go back to your country, Uganda.
Go home and build your country.
You
are doing here.
You are so corrupt. Every time you look here, you are every time.
Otago, wait. Let's switch gears real quick. This shows
let's go on sugar.
Let me ask you this question.
Let's go.
The reason why Kenya sugar industry collapsed,
yes,
and you've been fighting this for a while,
yes,
what was the where did we go wrong?
Yes, correct. Now this is an area where we have to guide the debate. Kenya sugar industries are experiencing problems because of multiple factors. The first one is the Ministry of Trade and the National Treasury, Kenya Revenue Authority, who control the trade of importation of sugar. They over-license importers to the extent that the deficit of 200,000 metric tons that this country needs. Then these barons usually then bring over flood our market and our sugar does not have a market to sell. So problem number one, over-licensing. This is so practical that President Uhuru, this year, he came in the National Assembly, where we had a joint sitting, and put on his list of ministers of shame, accused of corruption, one, Felix Koskei, because of licensing sugar. It's that real. The second challenge is that the cost of production of sugar is unnecessarily high, something that can be sorted out by the government in the sense that you can lower the cost of fuel, oils and lubricants that participate in this production. You can low subsidize the fertilizer as other countries do. The third problem is the challenge of taxation. Taxation is very high in Kenya. You have the sugar development levy, you have cess, you have all manner of duties that are charged on the farmer, and therefore it makes it expensive. Finally, there is the challenge of management
and mismanagement.
And on this matter, because I'm right on the front line in addressing it, I want us to respect the courts of Kenya, which are not like some of the kangaroo courts in Africa, whose country is Matanga knows. We want to respect the court of Kenya because it has directed that I should not discuss the case between me and Kidero until the matter is heard. The matter is heard and determined.
Okay, can I ask you this real quick? Maybe you can answer this.
Until it is heard and determined. However, that has got nothing to do with Uganda.
Let me help.
It has nothing to do with Uganda. Can you hold your ass? Now,
you see, that's not very good English. On a national TV television, the senator, you say you have manners?
Yes.
Finish.
So I was finishing. But what I need to assure Kenyans is that as we respect the directive of the court, I did not take myself to court. I was invited to go to court by my brother, the governor of Nairobi, Dr. Evans Kidero. I have gone to court on his invitation, and I'm glad to tell Kenyans that I have submitted responding affidavits that are solid that will prove my case.
This same brother of yours that you call a governor, you called him a thief. You said he's the one who stole from Mumias. You yourself, your words on TV.
I want to help you by telling you, if you go that route of using certain English words in describing which I used at that time, then you are being contemptuous of court. For now, let it hang. I have proved that I had a case by making the responding affidavits, and it will rest there. In the fullness of time, the matter will be heard. It will be determined.
Are you taking me back then?
Yes.
Take back what you said about Kidero and company.
No. If I was, his initial request was that I apologize.
Yes.
I did not.
Are you going to apologize?
At that time has now been overtaken. Because we have already gone to court.
You can see, let me now sympathize with my brother senator. Part of the problem of the sugar industry in East Africa, not only Uganda, Kenya, and let me be more organized, is Kenya's production of sugar is far, far expensive. There are no subsidies on equipment. The taxes are too high. The soil is very poor. In those areas, you need a lot of fertilizers compared to our place. For example, Uganda. The soils are fertile. The amount of fertilizer, let's go down the deep.
Get to the point, Matanga.
Coming back to the reality is the mismanagement is the blame of all this sugar.
That's what it boils down to.
It boils down to that. Why can't we give solutions? For example, my brother Harare would have come with a solution like this. Nzoia, Muhoroni, Mumias, what capacity do they have? Can we allow, and this is what a good MP would do, a representative of the people who are suffering. They depend on this sugar to educate the children. They depended on it to educate Kalwale to be where he is, however bad he is. So when you look at this, you should put a framework on how to resolve the conflict. Me, I would say, the government should come in by allowing these factories themselves instead of the sugar barons. Because indeed, there are sugar barons.
Okay,
allow the factories to import. Allow the factories to import the capacity to feed up the capacity.
Okay, real quick. Dattari, the president went to your county. You all showed up for that big event.
Yes,
he promised you guys and he gave you guys 1 billion shillings.
Yes, he did.
You needed 5 billion.
Yes, sir.
He threw in 1 billion. Did that help? Yes, no.
He did a good thing. We were very expectant that things were starting to look good. But when then he went and they opened up these floodgates of Brazilian sugar to come into the country, then it looked like he was merely calling bluff when he brought that check. of 1 billion shillings. Yeah. We want to encourage him. And I want Kenyans to know that this is just the beginning of the struggle of sugar. Whether they bring here Matanga again and again, the deal between Kenya and Uganda will not fly.
There is no deal. It's a communique.
It's not going to
that
fly.
You have
and
to
we'll stop it.
But
right.
Let me...
Gentlemen, let's take
yes.
a little break, come back, okay?
Yes. Yes.
Dottari and
yes.
Dottari?
Yes.
Let's touch a little on the ICC. There's a big event that happened this past week.
He has grizzled with me on most of them. He told me in the conference.
On ICC.
ICC,
yes.
You know, there's a big, you know, okay. The ruling.
It doesn't
ICC.
It doesn't
I'll tell you. This thing of ICC.
Let's take a break. Let's take a break. Let's yeah. take a break. Let's pay some bills, come back, talk some more, and then we'll wind up with sugar again.
Matanga, where did you say you are going to injure?
I have not received. And one problem.
Did he just get up?
No, look at this guy. One problem. He thinks that I have refused.
Please go.
I'm not refused.
Dr. Matanga, Koinange Jeff, the hashtag Matanga Khalwale. We're taking a break. I don't know.
Am I the only person you fear? Am I the only person you fear about amongst all these people?
No.
What have I taken your food?
Because I don't know who brought you here.
Back in a moment.
They should have brought somebody from the embassy.